Yeah? Everybody. Good. Bought this sweet, sweet hoodie at Walmart yesterday. Doesn't have Anakin on it, that's pretty good. No, every time I feel like I have a hoodie on, especially a mic, I feel like I'm on a freestyle. Is everybody okay with that? I'm gonna do a little freestyle. Alright, let's go. Let's go. Let's check it. Let's check it. Yo. Little Miss Muffet sat on her tough fit, thinking about curtain ways, and then she's like, I'm lazy as fuck, and I don't want to make curtain ways, so I'm just gonna sit on my tough fit. Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water, cause they ain't about this corporate bottled water system, and they drink organic. Fuck the system! Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall cause he had no furniture at all. And he's like looking at this wall and he's like, man, that's cozy, I'm gonna go sit on that. Yes, I'm doing this today. That's right. So, let's cut it with the freestyle, that's good. Alright, so I was reading in the news the other day that the Energizer Bunny got arrested. That's right, he was charged with battery. Can you believe that? Oh my gosh! So, also I was looking up too in the news that there was a fire at the circus. Man, that was intense. And then the last story I looked up as well too was this Marine. He had survived a pepper spray and mustard gas attack. Yeah, they're calling him a seasoned veteran now. So, I switched over, I was looking up some personal stuff on Google. I was Googling impotence online, but you know what? Nothing came up. I was also looking up some videos on YouTube, and then I saw one about Peter Pan, and he was in a boxing match. And I was watching it, and then I realized that when Peter Pan, when he throws punches, they never land. Yeah, it's just as bad as a belt made out of watches. It's a waste of time. It's actually it's a lot better than that time I had tried to consume a clock. That was time consuming. But I decided I'm gonna go out, I'm gonna go play a little bit. I brought my boomerang, and I actually forgot how to throw a boomerang, but then it came back to me. And then I was also gonna try to do some juggling, but I realized I didn't have the balls for it either. But I was outside, it reminded me of that time that I went to a ranch, and there was the farmhand there, he was giving me a tour, and I noticed something was different about how they raised their cattle. They weren't eating like regular grass and stuff, they were actually eating marijuana. And I was like, do you realize you're raising your stakes high? He glared at me. And then there was this one bull that was out in the distance. They made him beef, ironically. And I noticed he had an insatiable need to masturbate. And I was like, dude, beef's stroking off. See that? Again, another player for the rancher. But I told him that he should punish him. I was like, dude, you need to punish him. You need to ground him. You need to ground beef right now. But the only problem with that was that the butcher, he had backed up into his meat grinder. Yeah, he got a little behind in his work. But all the meanwhile, he brought me to another place where they showed me where they milked the cows. And there was this one cow who said, don't you don't want to drink milk from him, it's bad. And I was like, dude, spoiler alert, come on. But in the distance though, I saw this building on fire. It was a friend that had a bakery that was burning down to the ground. And the guy was out there, and I was like, dude, do you realize your business is toast? And I told him, like, look, maybe you could get a job as a banker, but he kept losing interest. But it reminded me of, I don't know why, but oddly enough, it reminded me of that time I was in this production about puns. It just turned out it was a play on words. And also, I came up with some puns, actually, to submit to a pun contest. I got like 10 puns to enter in, hoping that one would win, but no pun intended did. Alright. Are we alive out there? Everybody good?
Yeah!
Good, that was good. Alright, so anybody have any pets? Any pets? What do you got?
I have a dog.
What kind of dog?
German Shepherd.
German Shepherd? Dang, those are athletic dogs. I wish I could be like a German Shepherd though, and they're just so robust and everything. But no, that's cool. What do you name your dog?
It's
Kane.
Kane.
Like a whipping cane or whatever.
Like Kane.
Oh, a Cain and Abel, like he killed his brother or whatever.
K-A-N-E-K.
Okay. Cool, gotcha.
You know the pro wrestler, Kane, the big red guy?
Right.
Yeah, no, seriously.
No, hey, but you know what, though? I did watch wrestling when I was in, like, fourth grade and stuff. I grew up, so don't worry about that.
That's cool. I think a million people would disagree with you, but that's cool.
Yeah, and I disagree with, yeah, 50 million of them. But anyway, I have a couple of dogs as well, too. But there are some people out there that they kind of get to me that when they speak, as if they know exactly what their dog is saying, like they're Caesar Milan and shit, though. Like, I went to my friend's house, and his dog's name is Bark Barkley, and he's like a basketball fan. And I sit down, and Barkley comes up, and he's like, wag his tail, and I said, hey, Barkley! Barkley says, I'm excited to see you! And I was like, really? Like, so yeah, that's exactly what he's saying. I'm like, yeah, I can figure his wag his tail. But then, then he goes on, he's like, yeah, Barkley says, you smell funny. You smell funny like you've been inside your house all week, that you've been eating Hot Pockets, that you cannot contribute to society, and that you've been, you know, the lazy slob that you need to go to work and contribute, that you need to maybe do something for once in your life, or maybe you have some deep-rooted psychological issues that you need to go to a psychiatrist and get some medication so you end up killing yourself so that we don't have to clean up that mess, and so that... Because we're lazy and we don't have to do that. Yeah, Barkley says all that. He says that about you. I'm like, really? He's licking his butthole. You got all that from that? I'm like, all right, okay. You want me to tell you it's about that time I got into a fight with Arnold Schwarzenegger?
Yeah.
Woo. Okay.
Share it.
All right, so I went to the store one day, and I saw this cute little baby, and I was like, I want to make this baby laugh, because I think it's funny when they laugh. You know, that little... A little cute laugh that they do. I was like, all right. So, what can I do to make this kid laugh? So I was like, all right, I'm gonna pretend to be like Krusty the Clown. So I go up to the kid and I was just like, hey. And the kid just starts crying. There he's like, and I was like, oh no. I'm like, this isn't going well. So I'm like, all right, what can I do to turn myself around? I'm like, all right, let me do SpongeBob. Kids like SpongeBob. So I go to the kid and I was like, I'm ready, Eddie. Jellyfishing.
SpongeBob, that's so funny.
Oh yeah, SpongeBob, real funny.
You're killing it, SpongeBob.
And that didn't help because then the kid just starts wailing, just like, no. So then I get a tap on my shoulder. I turn around, and this guy's like, so you got to listen to me. Get down and do it now. It's like, oh my gosh, it's Arnold Schwarzenegger. I'm like, dude, so excited to see you. I'm a fan. That's cool. I don't know what you said, but whatever. And he's like, so you got to listen to me. You got to knock it off. And I'm going to jiggle you all the way. And I was like, dude, are you like calling me out? I'm like, all right, well, I'm not going to fight you. Don't worry about it. But then there's a voice right behind him, and it was Kermit, and he's like, no, it's not easy being green, but I bet you it's easy to kick your ass. I was like, dude, calm down, Kermit. I'm not trying for a fight. Mickey Mouse right behind me, he's like, bitch, please don't kick your ass anyway. I was like, Mickey, stop. Don't. But Shaggy and Scooby didn't help out either, because they were like, oh, dude, there's totally going to be a fight. He's like, uh-oh, Reggie. I said, great. This is escalating to a point where I don't want it to be. And then Arnold's just like, I was like, dude, really? And the Sean Connery was there. I'm glad he was there to translate, because he's all, what did you say, Arnold? Oh, that's right. You say, I'm gonna kick your pansy ass motherfucker into the next Terminator movie, which is never. And I was like, oh, really? Okay. How am I gonna get pumped up? And then how am I gonna get ready for this fight? So, remember my voice of my Master Yoda? He's all, do or do not. There is no try. Especially if your nuts are on the line. I'm like, Okay. Like, all right, that might help me. So I was getting pumped up. I was getting ferocious like Chewbacca. Just. I was getting set like Donald Duck. Just. And then all of a sudden, bam, knocked out. And then I wake up in the parking lot, and I noticed Gollum was over me. He's all,
is the princess okay to fix the knocks out?
And then I realized at that time that maybe I smoked a little bit too much money and got in a fight with security and got kicked out. But I like that guy fight on the Schwarzenegger, so I'm sick of that. But anyway, that's my time. Thank you very much.